morning. This is the day that the Lord has made, and let us rejoice and be glad in it. Announcements. Let's start with page 1, 2, 4, 5, whatever it is. Due to a lack of interest, our the ministry and fellowship day in the district has been canceled. That would have been November 16th, but there was not enough interest to continue, so take that off your calendar. The 27th, Wednesday, we will have a community-wide Thanksgiving service at the Catholic Church, St. Charles Catholic Church, 7 o'clock. And bring a canned good with you for the food bank. That's what we're going to be collecting there for that. If you bring a canned good or something non-perishable, we appreciate it. Prayer ministry of youth is still ongoing on that table in the back room. Methodist women will be doing their thank offering on November 14th at 7. And Judy and Janet, get ready. You're the host and hostess here. I forgot to bring my potato bag, but we're still going to need change to transport potatoes. That's those little white bags you see on both sides. There's one. Dawn has one back here. Grab one and use it as your piggy bank for the next couple weeks and bring it in. We need money to transport potatoes wherever they're to go. Bible studies, Monday night will be visitation, correct? And then on Wednesday, Fairmont City, Bible study at 7 o'clock. And food bank, Tuesday will be delivering food to the local high-rises and homes, if you can help, 9 o'clock. And then the following week, on the third Tuesday, we'll be giving food from 1:30 to 4, right in our food pantry down there in town. Community container practice today at 7, is that correct?
Tomorrow.
Oh, that's why it's 7, it's tomorrow. The 12th, the ladies will be going to New Hope, the daily bread ministry. If you can help tomorrow, we're going to be doing some work here to get ready. If you can help, get a hold of Jane. She can't call you, she's a busy woman. And blessings to the Hunters will be at noon on the 16th. I'm not sure where that is, but I think Mike and Bud are both involved in that. And there might be more to follow.
It's up at Longshot.
Oh, it'll be Longshot, up there where they sell the guns, up above office. The community get that on the 17th will be 2. The office will be closed through the Thanksgiving opportunities this week. Worship after service today. Youth at 5. Also, there's a short mission meeting after church. 11th, trustees, which is tomorrow night. And the 13th is Christian Ed Choir, handbells. We know the drill there. United Methodist Women again on the 14th. Coming up next week will be our fellowship dinner, covered dish after service. And that week, the 21st will be a dollar dinner. And our local love dinner that we do here every year is coming up on the 24th. And there's a sign-up sheet coming around if you can donate something or time or delivery or whatever. You can use your help if you can help out. Any other announcements that I missed? She needs 4 dozen cupcakes if somebody can bake cupcakes for Tuesday. That's for New Hope.
What's that mean?
They're talking logistics back here. Okay, Amy, what do you got?
It's time for angels. I know it's really not time, but it's going to be a quick turnaround this year. We're going to take you back by December 8th. So if you want to get a head start in your shopping, you want to take an angel for the Edgewood tree, come and see me at the church. We're ready.
Trust me, I've been listening to Christmas.
Okay, any other appreciate a good hello, and God bless you.
Thank you. come forward, let us take this opportunity to prepare our hearts and our minds for the giving of our tithes. Concerns. First of all, do we have a report from the youth?
You give us thankful for a good marching band season, family and friends, warm clothes, and answered prayers.
Thank you. And I have here a list of prayer requests from the ACT class. Johnny and Cheryl Kelvin, Emily McClintock, Paula Wheeler, our country, our government, the shootings in Mexico, Josie Schreckenboss, Dawn Davis, myself, Austin Newcomb, and Alexa McCauley. We will be lifting those up in prayer. What joys do you have today? Praise God. Her sister-in-law is cancer-free. So far. Any others? Bob?
We went to visit my father yesterday. He's in a home up in Meadville, Juniper Village, if anybody knows where it is. Anyway, he had a rough transition from actually going to Florida about this time last year. Just before Christmas, he got hit with a truck, and they had a broken hip, and he was through all the things that, you know, the therapy and all those things, and we moved him back up here to his home, not his home, to my sister's, and she had some problems, she couldn't keep him in there. Well, he ended up in Juniper Village. He was a rough, you know, you don't want to leave your home, you don't want to give up your driver's license, you don't, these things don't happen in your life. Well, they did. And he's finally come to grips with the fact that he's going to be there. He's well taken care of, he seems happier, and I'm very grateful and very happy that he's got to this point in his life.
Praise God. Always a tough position to be put in. Any others? Mark.
My neighbor in a high rise came back from New York, and his eyelids were half open. I thought he had a stroke, you know, while he was away. Anyways, he got surgery at the VA hospital. They removed a growth in his sinuses, and he's doing great on that, and his eyelids are even open wide now. So I just like to praise and comment on that.
Good. Praise for Bob's neighbor. Any others?
I have a joy that both Redbank and Clarion are in the football playoffs, continue to be in the football playoffs.
Yes.
Yeah,
yes. Yeah, we traveled up to Clarion Friday night, went to the football game, and I can assure you it was cold. I'm glad the next game is during the day, 1 o'clock in the afternoon, I believe, but hopefully it'll be a little warmer. Benny?
I got my latest test results back. I'm still cancer-free after 3 years.
Praise God. Any others? Prayer requests?
Unspoken.
Any other unspoken requests? Alexa. Okay. McCauley? Okay. Yeah. Okay, good. Alexa McCauley.
Karen King.
Karen King. There's one over here.
The Dick Heitzen Ryder family. That's Pat Morris's brother. He passed this week.
The Dick Heitzen Ryder Rider family.
I also, about that, and I were talking. My mother had a nephew named Dick Heitzenreiter, and it's not the same one, but Pat and I decided that we are related, so that's a good one.
That's right.
It might be a prayer concern on Pat's part. It's a praise on Bob's part.
Hey, we're still talking. That's a good thing.
All right. Any others?
We pray for all veterans and all
yes.
military people that are deployed or in the States, wherever they are, all military people, police, firemen, all people in the
sure. state.
Volunteers.
So many that serve us. Yeah.
My sister, Elaine Hedrick.
Elaine?
She fell in love before.
Carl Reese, he fell.
Carl. Carl Reese, Elaine Hedrick. Traveling Mercies for, is this a club? For the club, the youth are going to the Holocaust Museum? Any others? Let's go to prayer. Dear God, we do thank you and praise you for this day, allowing us, giving us another day that you have created just for us to not only enjoy, but also to continue to serve you. Father, we just thank you and praise you for all the blessings that you bring upon us and send to us each and every day. And we just want to pause and just say thank you for those blessings that we don't often recognize, let alone acknowledge. Father, we always tend to praise you for the big blessings, but we know that there are times when you're blessing us and we're not even aware of it. And we just want to take this opportunity to thank you and praise you for all the blessings that you give to us. And we just, first of all, praise you for answering our prayers. And through the people of our church and the people of our community, we receive testimony of so many answered prayers, and we just give you the praise for that. Father, we do praise you that we have so many in our community that are cancer-free at this time. We just thank you and praise you that you are still doing your healing upon so many. Father, we thank you for Bob's father. It's a tough road to go into, and it's tough to be on the other side of the fence when you have to put a loved one in a home. And we just thank you and praise you that he has finally found peace and comfort with that decision. And we pray for that neighbor of Bob's in the high rise. We just give you the praise that you did your healing upon him as well. And we pray for continued healing. Father, we pray for many names every Sunday that are listed in our bulletin, and we pray for many that are mentioned, even these names that are mentioned here this morning and the names that are written down on this piece of paper from the Acts class. We just lift them all up to you, praying for your healing touch upon them, continued healing. Father, you know the circumstances. You know what the issues are that they're going through. You know each person personally and intimately. We just lift them up to you. We give them to you completely, and we wait with great anticipation and expectation of our answered prayers. Father, we pray for our country, we pray for our government, we pray for our president, all those that represent us. We pray for a revival to occur within our nation, but not only within our nation, but we pray for a revival to occur within your church, your universal church, and our United Methodist Church at this time. We are soon to go to General Conference, and there are major decisions about